What is going on, everyone? Welcome to today's video. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Ben Richardson. I'm a personal trainer. I'm also a chemical engineer. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about sleep and testosterone, and I'm going to give you 11 sleeping tips to boost testosterone. If this is your first time here, again, my name's Ben Richardson. I am here to help men reclaim their masculinity by boosting their testosterone levels through things like fitness, nutrition, and lifestyle decisions that they make in general. For the past few decades, testosterone levels in men has been on the decline, and it's a huge problem in our society. So I am here to build a community of men who want to fix that and rise above it. So if you're interested in being a part of that, go ahead and hit the subscribe button, because I do post videos just like this one every single week. All right, let's talk about sleep and testosterone. Sleep is one of the most important areas in your life to prioritize to optimize your testosterone levels naturally. You can eat a perfect diet, follow a perfect workout plan, and stay away from all of the endocrine disrupting chemicals out there that do damage your testosterone health. But if you don't get enough good quality sleep, the effectiveness of all of your efforts is going to take a hit, because sleep makes that big of a difference. So this video is going to be an extremely thorough and comprehensive guide to sleeping better. So make sure you stick around for all of the tips, because if you use all of them simultaneously, you are going to get the best and the fastest results. Let's dive in. Tip number one is to stop using the snooze button when you wake up in the morning. So if you don't really do this, then that's great. Stay away from doing it. But it's a habit that many of us have developed over the years, so I think it's definitely worth mentioning. Hitting the snooze button really screws up your body's natural alarm clock, because when you go to sleep for another 7 to 10 minutes after your alarm goes off in the morning, you're not entering into a restful state of sleep that is productive for your body. You're just kind of lazily laying there, not getting up, and that's really all you're doing. It also makes falling asleep at night much more difficult, because you're practically training your body to wake up after spending 7 to 10 minutes trying to fall asleep. Your body operates on a circadian rhythm. Your hunger levels operate on this rhythm. Your energy levels, your libido, and all of these are regulated by your hormones. And guess what? Testosterone is a hormone. A large portion of testosterone production actually takes place while you're sleeping, and that's one of the reasons why getting into a solid routine is so important, because it sends your body into a more structured rhythm. So stop hitting the snooze button, put your phone or your alarm clock on the other side of the room that you're sleeping in, so that you physically have to wake up in the morning to turn your alarm clock off. Don't put it by your bed and make it easy for you to just hit the snooze button and go back to sleep. I know it sucks, but your body will adjust after a few days. Tip number two is to sleep naked. So lower temperatures are more optimal for testosterone synthesis. That's why your balls are in a pouch outside of your body, because cooler temperatures are best for testosterone production. And that is where 95% of your testosterone production takes place, in the late egg cells in your nutsack. So sleeping naked is going to keep your balls cool throughout the night, and it's also going to optimize blood flow throughout your body too. So when you're wearing clothes on your legs, like underwear or shorts, sweatpants, pajama bottoms, whatever you might wear, when you wear those throughout the night, it can mildly restrict blood flow to your legs. And it may not seem like that big of a deal, but keep in mind that you're laying there for 7 to 8 hours, and you want optimal blood flow below your waist, because that is in fact where your balls are, below your waist. You're not going to get optimal blood flow down there, even if your waist is mildly restricted. So go ahead and just sleep naked. Tip number three is to buy some blue light blocking glasses and put them on a couple hours before you go to bed. Blue light interferes with the release of relaxation hormones, because it essentially sends signals to your body that tell it that it's time to wake up instead of go to sleep. There's a lot of blue light in sunlight, so it does make sense that being exposed to this tells your body to wake up, because that's when our bodies are meant to be awake, is during the day. So when the sun goes down and you continue to expose yourself to too much blue light from things like your phone screens, your TVs, or your computers, it can mess with your sleeping pattern or your ability to fall asleep. So getting some blue light blocking glasses, that can help this, because your eyes are particularly sensitive to that blue light exposure, and blocking that out can definitely help you fall asleep faster. Tip number four is to change the display settings on your phone to warmer colors to reduce the emission of blue light. So you can go into the settings of most phones and computers to change the display colors so that it emits warmer colors rather than brighter colors. This is also going to reduce the amount of blue light exposure. And if you take just a minute to look up how to do it on your specific device, it's pretty easy to figure out. Some of the phones have night mode, but I'd actually encourage you to add some kind of color filter to minimize the amount of blue light that's being emitted from the screen. Usually the default night mode setting leaves some brightness in the display, and it's just best to get rid of that completely. So if you stack this on top of using blue light blocking glasses, you're definitely going to notice an improvement in your ability to fall asleep. Tip number five is to get outside a few times throughout the day. This is pretty much the opposite of reducing blue light exposure at night. So during the day, you want to increase your exposure to sunlight. As I'm sure you can imagine, sunlight is way better than blue light from phone screens or TV screens because it's a natural source of light. But spending more time outside when the sun is still out, that's a great way to dial in your circadian rhythm. Not only is this going to help you sleep at night, but it's going to give you more energy throughout the day. So if you haven't checked out my video on how to boost your testosterone by walking, I would definitely check that out after you're done watching this one. I go into a lot more detail on how walking outside and being outside, increasing sunlight exposure, and improving blood flow are all beneficial to your testosterone health. So you want to make sure you can expose as much of your skin as possible to the sun to maximize sunlight absorption. But just make sure that you don't get sunburned. And I'm making this video during the winter time, so I'm not particularly concerned about it right now. But during the summer months, just make sure that you're not burning yourself from overdoing it on this one. Tip number six is to eat foods that induce the release of relaxation hormones before you go to bed. Some foods that work great are foods with natural sugars and dairy products. Bone broth or collagen are also great because they're rich in the amino acids proline and glycine. And these amino acids aren't very high in muscle meats, so getting them into your diet is a good thing to do anyway. But glycine effectively induces the release of relaxation hormones to prepare your body for sleep. So it's good to consume before you go to bed. Fruit is always a good option too because of the natural sugars in it. You don't want to be eating junk food before bed, but fruits and natural sweeteners are great. Milk and even a small amount of natural ice cream are also good options here. Sort of a nightcap drink that I make is a simple concoction of some grass-fed milk and either some honey or raw cane sugar. You don't need much because if you eat or drink too much before you go to bed, you might have a little bit of difficulty falling asleep, but getting a small serving in of foods like these can prepare your body to enter into a long and restful night of sleep. Tip number seven is to sleep in a completely dark room. So if you have one of those digital alarm clocks with the LED display, I'd recommend just using your phone as an alarm clock instead because it won't emit light in the room that you sleep in. Getting some thick black curtains for the windows in your room that you sleep in, that's also a good way to minimize the amount of light that comes in from the outside. In an ideal world, you'd sleep in complete darkness and you even wouldn't be able to see that much after your eyes adjusted, but you also kind of want to be able to see just in case you have to get up to use the bathroom in the middle of the night. I mean, you don't want it to become a safety hazard for yourself or anything, but minimizing the amount of light in your room, in the room that you sleep in, that's definitely going to help you fall asleep faster, and it's going to help you sleep better throughout the night. Tip number eight is to lower the temperature of the room that you sleep in. So, like I mentioned earlier, lower temperatures are better to boost testosterone and increase testosterone production. Temperature is an extremely important driving factor in any chemical reaction. Maybe some of you chemistry nerds recall the Arrhenius relationship that describes the temperature dependence on chemical reaction rates. But whether it's a reaction taking place in an industrial chemical reactor or it's a biochemical reaction that's taking place in your body, temperature is a crucial driving factor in chemical kinetics. And chemical kinetics is the study of reaction rates. So in the case of testosterone synthesis, lower temperatures are actually best and optimal for testosterone testosterone output. Anywhere between 62 to 68 Fahrenheit is a good temperature for the room that you sleep in. It just kind of depends on your preference with this one and what you can tolerate, but stacking this on top of sleeping naked, that's going to be a great way to maximize your testosterone output throughout the night, and it's going to help you sleep like a hibernating bear. Tip number 9 is to physically write out a to-do list before you go to bed. So I say write one out because staying away from blue light emitting screens, it's probably best here. I'm kind of an old school guy too, and I like to do stuff by hand. But I think taking some time to think about what you need to accomplish the next day, it's a great way to kind of subconsciously prepare yourself to sleep well. Because you know you have things to do the next day, and that means that you're going to need to get a good night of sleep in order to get all of those things done. I also think this is just a great thing to do for general productivity. It's very satisfying to make a list of things to do and then check them off or cross them out as you do each one of them. So if you're not aware, I'm a big fan of intermittent fasting, and I've made several other videos about intermittent fasting and testosterone. Feel free to check those out up there after you're done watching this one. But I'm mentioning it here because I skip breakfast and I actually fast throughout most of the morning. And that's when I like to get the bulk of my most daunting tasks done, because fasting actually gives me a nice boost in cognition and brain function, and that's certainly one of the benefits of intermittent fasting. So anyways, plan tomorrow tonight before you go to bed, and it'll help you get more done and improve your sleep quality. Tip number 10 is to turn your Wi-Fi router off at night. The radio waves emitted by your Wi-Fi router to communicate with all of the wireless devices, those can interfere with your body's ability to release relaxation hormones that are going to prepare you to enter a deep state of sleep. All the exposure to electromagnetic radiation that we're surrounded by now from wireless devices like computers, cell phones, and TV, it's a relatively new environment for humans to be in. So I will just say that personally, I thought this one was a little bit out there when I first started hearing about it. Other internet influencers swore by this and health blogs and whatnot, but when I started doing this, I noticed pretty much immediate results. I started falling asleep easier, I stayed asleep throughout the entire night for 7 to 8 hours, and that is exactly what you want, so give this one a shot. And then tip number 11 is to go to sleep and wake up around the same time every single day. This one sort of ties into the first one because it kind of all circles back into mastering your circadian rhythm. Waking up and going to bed at the same time is going to set a natural pattern for your body to function on. Now, because of this one, I don't really believe in the whole concept of morning persons or night owls, because I have personally gone through seasons in my life where I've had to do both. When I was in college, I was sort of more like a night owl because I stayed up late in the library studying and reading and doing homework assignments with my classmates. But now that I'm working on a 9-to-5 job, I wake up and I go to bed way earlier than I did in college. My body just adjusted to whatever my schedule demanded of it, so I'm not really a believer in the whole morning person or night owl thing. But either way, I think it's a good thing to set kind of a general pattern for when you go to bed and when you wake up. This can be a little tricky because it's easy to sleep in on the weekend and then stay up late on a Friday night, and then that's usually not consistent with your sleeping schedule throughout the work week. But it really is best to try to keep that sleeping window as similar as possible. That's really gonna help you sleep better at night, so just being a little more disciplined with going to bed on time and waking up on time without using the snooze button, making sure that that schedule is consistent, is going to help you sleep a lot better. So there you go. Those are 11 sleeping tips to boost testosterone. Lots of people struggle with sleep, but going through this video and seeing all the things that improve sleep quality, it kind of sheds a little bit of light onto why people struggle with it. We stare at computer screens and we're inside all day long. We don't get a lot of sunlight exposures, and we watch TV to relax in the evening and late at night. We go to bed and we wake up early during the week, and then we stay out late on the weekends and we sleep in. And those are just to name a few. Being a little disciplined and following a little bit tighter of a schedule really can do wonders for your sleep, which is ultimately going to tremendously help boost your testosterone levels naturally. But anyway, that's it for this video. If you liked it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And again, if you're new here and you've made it this far, I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel. I'm looking to build a community of men who are looking to transform their lives like I did by boosting their testosterone levels naturally. Modern men are weak and lazy and undisciplined because they don't pay close enough attention to their testosterone health. And it really is becoming a huge problem in our world, so if you want to do something about that, go ahead and subscribe and turn the notification bells on too so that you don't miss out on any of my latest videos. If you made it this far, I do appreciate your support. I hope you got a lot out of this video too, so good luck in boosting your testosterone, good luck sleeping better, thanks again for watching everyone, take care, and I'll see you in the next video.